And as we've reported, 8 fresh faces are now holding positions in the Prime Minister's cabinet. One of those is the country's new Labour Minister. And Minister Kellie Leitch, the Harper government's new Minister of Labour and Minister of Status of Women, joins us now live from Ottawa. Minister, thank you for taking the time. Appreciate it.
Delighted to be here.
So right now, we're dealing with an unemployment rate that is quite high in this country. Do you recognize how challenging this portfolio is about to become for you?
Well, you know, the government is focused on making sure that we have a strong economy, and that's about jobs and long-term prosperity. We've been focused since putting forward the first economic action plan on just that, making sure that we have a strong economy. In the most recent budget, Economic Action Plan 2013, one of the signature items was the Canada Jobs Grant, focused exactly on what you're talking about, making sure Canadians are employed, that they have the skills they need so that they can enter into the workforce. So I'm delighted to be asked to take on this important responsibility, and I'm looking forward to getting to work.
And I should have congratulated you off the top, so congratulations as well.
Thank you.
What will be some of your priorities in Parliament as Labour Minister, as Minister of Status of Women as well?
Well, on the status of women's side, as you know, the government has been focused on a number of items, primarily making sure that economic security for women is front and center, but also violence against women. Most recently, we've focused on making sure that matrimonial rights, property rights were put forward to make sure that women and children on reserves were treated fairly and equally. So we'll continue along that path of making sure that that women are protected and economically secure. And on the labor side, again, it's focus on the economy, making sure that we have safe, productive workplaces so that all Canadians can contribute to the Canadian economy in a meaningful way so that we're growing the economy across the country. So, you know, I'm looking forward to, as I said, to this challenge. I think it's a great opportunity, and we have a fabulous team. You know, we have a stable number of ministers who have done excellent service, making sure that we have a strong, stable economy, particularly in the Prime Minister and Minister Flaherty. But now we have some new faces, and we'll have some new ideas at the table.
And speaking of the team, you're one of 4 women now brought into the front benches. What do you make of the Prime Minister's emphasis on women in high-profile positions?
Well, I think it's spectacular. You know, we have 12 women who are members of cabinet now, many in senior portfolios, whether that be Minister Lisa Raitt as the Minister of Transport, Rona Ambrose as the Minister of Health, Leona Aglukkaq is the Minister for the Environment, myself as the Minister of Labour, and numerous others. So I think we have a strong team with excellent representation, and we have a strong team across the front bench, whether they're male or female, but particularly delighted that we have 12 female ministers of the Crown.
More than just a minister, you're also a pediatric orthopedic surgeon. I don't know how you have the time. How might your experience in medicine help you as a cabinet minister now?
Well, look, I'm very pleased that the Prime Minister and the Chief of Surgery at CHEO, the Children's Hospital here in Eastern Ontario, Baxter Willis, have been supportive of me continuing to maintain my license. You know, I'm awaiting the Ethics Commissioner, and each time I receive a change in role, the Ethics Commissioner has to make a statement. But my experience as a pediatric surgeon and also as a Chair and Chief of Surgery was about managing people and making sure that they had a productive and safe workplace. That's what I did as a Chief of Surgery. So it was a small, much smaller role. This is a much larger role. But again, it's about making sure that we have a productive workplace so that Canadians feel that they're contributing as much as they can to the economy. And in the case of the hospital, making sure that we have a safe workplace so that children get home safe and can get back on the playground.
I know that the folks at CHEO are so proud of you. And I heard that you have, I don't even know how, have been volunteering there to date. You've been able to find the time. Do you think you'll be able to maintain that?
Well, my goal is to continue to maintain my license. And I'm just, as I said, waiting on the Ethics Commissioner to come back to me whether I'm allowed to do that, that there's no conflicts associated with me doing that. But I've been delighted that the CHEO family has been fabulous. They've welcomed me with open arms, and I've been able to work there and maintain my license for the last 18 months.
Kellie Leitch, the Harper government's new Minister of Labour and Minister of Status of Women, really appreciate you taking the time, and congratulations once again.
Thanks for having me.